Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Today. Hope you're doing well. So today we're about to begin our space updates with the Ship 26 rollout. For the last few years, SpaceX teams have been working hard to get their Starship spacecraft ready for launch, and the pace of this program has reached its peak since the beginning of 2023. Just a couple days before, they successfully carried out the static fire test of their Super Heavy Booster B7. Though the test has been completed successfully, there are some minor glitches, and presently engineers are working on collecting data from the test as well as on those minor glitches. Moreover, inspectors are going on the orbital launch pad to assess the wear and tear of the pad from the hot blast of roaring raptors. While these have been going on to secure the orbital flight, SpaceX teams have also been working upon the successors of Starship prototypes to prepare them for future tests and launches. As per reports, recently the teams have rolled out a strange, somewhat different Starship prototype from its Starbase, Texas factory, to a nearby test site, and that ship prototype is Ship 26. If we look back into SpaceX Starship production history, we can find that the stacking procedure of Ship 26 has been started in the month of October 2022. As usual, the work began with stacking the nose cone section first. Reports say that by the first week of January 2023, the workers have been able to finish the welding of the main section as well as stacking it to its full 50-meter height. According to a tweet by the Ring Watchers dated the 4th of January 2023, it stated that finishing off a productive day at the production site, Ship 26 has been removed from the welding turntable in the high bay. It will now be outfitted with other pieces, such as its raceway. SpaceX engineers have spent more than 40 days after the full stack to complete the necessary wiring and other installations before rolling it out to the test site. During the second week of February 2023, Ship 26 was rolled out from the High Bay Assembly Facility and was transported to one of the two suborbital test pads. Sources state that on the 12th of February 2023, during the morning, SpaceX teams have finally lifted Ship 26 into suborbital Pad A. Chris Bergen of NASA Spaceflight tweeted, "Ship 26 is being placed on Pad A next to Ship 25 on Pad B." Ship 25, which is 4 months older than Ship 26, is presently sitting on the suborbital Pad B, just a couple of hundred feet away from Pad A, awaiting the upcoming test campaign of Raptor engines installed on it. Ship 26 presently doesn't have any engines installed, as it has to pass through the cryo-proof test first to verify whether the spacecraft is ready to get engines or not. If you've heard closely, then you can find that we have called Ship 26 strange and somewhat different. But why? No need to worry, we've got answers ready. Aside from a range of smaller design changes, there are three things in total that makes Ship 26 a bit strange. First of all, Ship 26 has no heat shields installed on it. If we study the major starships built throughout the last 2 years, such as S-20, S-21, S-22, S-24, and S-25, we can see that all of them have been installed with roughly 10,000 black ceramic heat shield tiles. These heat shield tiles are meant to save the spacecraft from melting down during atmospheric re-entry that causes tremendous heat and pressure. But having no shield installed, S-26 becomes strange at first sight. Then, throughout the whole Starship development history, starting from October 2020, we can see that every ship the company has completed, ranging from SN-8 to S-25, all of them has had four large flaps and form-fitting aero covers installed. The flaps and aero covers are used to control the ship during orbital re-entries, landing maneuvers, as well as the famous belly flop of the ship. But it's quite peculiar to see that Ship 26 has no flaps at all. Finally, and confusingly, Ship 26 has no payload bay of any kind. Now, having none of these three elements, Ship 26 becomes a smooth, featureless starship, mostly resembling a steel bullet that has no ability to return to Earth or deploy satellites. At first look, it seems like SpaceX has possibly made a big mistake. But the recent rollout of the ship and their plans to qualify the rocket for flight clearly shows that the company has intentionally made this bullet-like starship to serve some real purpose in the future. Now, that brings a question into our mind. What kind of purpose can this bullet-like starship serve? Ship 26 has no shield, no flaps, and no payload door, then what can it do? SpaceX till now didn't specify the answers. If we look back into SpaceX's plans for their starships, we can find that they've devised almost four variants of starship. Most popular two variants are the crew and tanker starships that have a heat shield and flaps installed on it. The third variant is a lunar lander that will be insulated and have no flaps or heat shield installed. One more of the fourth variant is the depot ship that will contain stretched tanks and is destined to stay in orbit permanently and store propellant for in-space refilling. Ship 26 is quite similar to the storage depot variant, as graphically rendered in Starship vehicle configuration for NASA's Human Landing System. So there's a possibility that Ship 26 is just a prototype version of the depot starship. Other than similarity in outward appearance, no other similarity on technical grounds can be found. Report says that there's no evidence that Ship 26 has exterior optical properties optimized for long-duration propellant storage. Ship 26 lacks any of the hardware likely needed for docking or propellant transfer. Moreover, that prototype has no extended propellant tanks that will be needed for any sort of in-orbit refueling. To remain operational in orbit for longer duration means reliance on solar power, but Ship 26 lacks in that matter too. Sources further state that even if an expendable starship like S-26 can already achieve SpaceX's reported target of 250 tons to low Earth orbit, 250 tons is only a fifth of a full propellant load. Both Ship 24 and Ship 25 have had their payload bays permanently sealed as Ship 26, and they too can serve for those tests. Therefore, use of Ship 26 still remains a question. One simple solution is that SpaceX just wants to do the cryo test first, then later they'll do the installation. It can serve as a time saver, as well as a money saver, where the spacecraft will get to test very fast, leaving behind the time-taking heat shield installation, and can also save money by first checking the spacecraft through proof tests, then continue installation, in order to save from loss during any mishap while the proof tests are going on. Whatever SpaceX will do is soon to be revealed. As for now, they have S-26 ready at Pad A for cryogenic proofing and structural testing. With successful completion, it's assumed that the booster will return to the Starbase factory for Raptor installation. Reports say Ship 27 would probably be more or less identical with no heat shields or flaps. However, Ship 27 will also have the first working payload bay on a starship that could be used to deploy payloads in orbit. According to some assumptions, Ship 26 and Ship 27 could be used to test out SpaceX's first Starship docking and propellant transfer test, which was referred to by NASA in late 2022. Whatever be the case, it's true that SpaceX is going to give us some marvelous gifts this year. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.